Lalit Modi's job offer letter to External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj's husband, Swaraj Kaushal. Lalit Modi wrote a letter to appoint Swaraj Kaushal as the alternate director of one of his companies, Indofil. However, he later withdrew the letter himself and it never reached the board of directors. The Congress is alleging that the very fact that a job offer was made suggests the proximity between the Swarajes and Lalit Modi, which can now not be denied. Meanwhile, Swaraj Kaushal has broken his silence on the controversy. He has reacted, stating that there was an offer made to him, but he refused. The request was later withdrawn.
Apart from the fact that there is admitted situation of the foreign minister's daughter being a lawyer, and she has every right to be, no problem. We are not concerned about her. Apart from the fact that the foreign minister's own ministry had no idea of this conversation by the head of that ministry, the foreign ministry, either with Mr. Vaz or with the UK Foreign Office or with the High Commissioner in India, there is now clear material to show that Mr. Lalit Modi offered a job to a close relative of the foreign minister, a job on his company as a director. The fact whether that job fructified or not, was taken or not, is totally irrelevant.
We have with us BJP spokesperson Nalin Kohli. Sir, there has been new correspondence which has come on light in which the Congress is alleging that Swaraj Kaushal has been offered to appear in the director as a director for Lalit Modi. Don't you think that this is a conflict of interest?
The media has been treating it as a job offer. I'm unable to understand how serving on a board, not as a full-time director, for probably 3 or 4 or 1 statutorily required board meeting qualifies as a job. Because, you know, you may be paid an amount as small as 500 rupees and perhaps as large as maybe 10 or 20,000 rupees a few times a year. Second is, did he accept it? Third, Mr. Swaraj Kaushal has been representing Mr. Lalit Modi for several years. Ms. Swaraj became the Minister for External Affairs only last year. Additionally, is the Congress now expecting a new norm where if a person becomes a minister or a government appointee, their spouse or children are expected to live separately? No longer have their own professional professional life, personal life. That can't be there. And what the Congress is trying to say, that there is a link between that. How can they even raise the argument? Mr. Swaraj Kaushal eventually declined, immediately declined. He never attended the meeting. So I'm unable to understand what's the issue.
But sir, given the current controversy surrounding Sushma Swaraj and Lalit Modi Allah affair in helping him get the visa and other travel documents, don't you think that the Swaraj Kaushal should have come out in open and declared this?
So Mr. Swaraj Kaushal or anybody, first, what's a lawyer? Lawyer represents a client. And it's fairly routine for lawyers, advocates to be on boards, to also chartered accountants do the same. What is the Congress party building its case on? The Congress party is building a case on that, please show us all the correspondence. Now, is that norm exist in the Congress party? The first family of the Congress party has been shrouded in secrecy forever. So if they want a norm where they would like to have an open discussion and have everything in public space, we can begin with the whereabouts of Mr. Rahul Gandhi. And we can also have details of his lunches, dinners, everything. But does that what the Congress want? You can't take a logic unnecessarily beyond a point.
And Deputy Editor Brijesh Pandey now joins me live on that controversy. Brijesh, the BJP using the fact and the statement by Swaraj Kaushal himself that he rejected that job offer as an attempt to deflate the Congress's charges while they claim conflict of interest in this case.
Well, BJP is very clear on one front that this particular controversy is just a controversy by which has been created by the Congress party to score some political point, because they say that if you go through the document carefully, there is no conflict of interest whatsoever. They are very clear about the fact that Swaraj Kaushal is a lawyer for Lalit Modi for more than 20 years. And they are saying that this particular position which was offered for him by Lalit Modi to him to appear on the board as an assistant director or to represent him on the board for 3-4 times doesn't constitute anything if he has not accepted the offer. So they are very clear about one thing, that if Swaraj Kaushal has not accepted the offer, then where on earth is there as a conflict of interest or any kind of impropriety that is being done by him? They are all saying that this is just an effort on the part of the Congress to score some political mileage during the ongoing Lalit Modi Sushma Swaraj controversy.
All right, Brijesh, thanks for that. Meanwhile, we also spoke with the CM. MD of Indofil, who is Larit Modi's father. Indofil is the company for which Swaraj was offered the director's position. Listen in.
The fact that such an offer was made in the first place suggests that there was a very proximate relationship that Mr. Lalit Modi has with Sushma Swaraj and her husband. Would you agree that the relationship is a close, not just professional, but a personal relationship?
No, Mr. Swaraj is working for our company for 20 years. At that time, when he joined, got the job, Sushma Swaraj was not even a minister.
And for 20 years, has he was it a professional relationship where you paid him a legal fee or not?
Professional relationship. It's a relationship between a lawyer and his client, and it is quite normal for a director who could not attend to find a person.
Yes.
And suggest that that person can attend that meeting.
So he was paid a legal fee for 20 years because Lalit Modi in an interview to me told me that Swaraj Kaushal would appear for him in courts pro bono. You are confirming that this was a professional relationship where Mr. Modi or your company paid Swaraj Kaushal for the services he gave as a lawyer?
No, Swaraj Kaushal is paid for the work he does for the company.
Right.
And he has not charged so far any penny for appearing for Lalit Modi. Other retainers which work for a company,
right,
if they also appear for any director or any other person.
So you paid him, He had a retainership with Indofil. Am I correct? He had a legal retainership with Indofil.
Did not require him to appear for Lalit Modi.
How would you describe the... the entire issue is of conflict of interest, sir. The fact is, the charge is that Sushma Swaraj and her husband were very close to Lalit Modi, which is why Sushma Swaraj, once she became Minister of External Affairs, perhaps went out of her way to help Lalit Modi get back his travel documents. Would you concede that this was a profession?
I can answer you, yes, my friend, because neither I am Sushma Swaraj nor I am Lalit Modi.
Are you distancing yourself today from your son? Because he is tweeting today about everyone, from Sonia Gandhi to Arun Jaitley. He has been tweeting about them, making various allegations against them. Are you distancing yourself from your son, sir?
He's a 50-year-old man and he's an independent person. He happened to be my son, but he's not asking me before he's tweeting anything.
Has he embarrassed the family as a result? Yours is one of the oldest
business
families.
Why should the family be embarrassed?
Has Lalit Modi ji embarrassed the family in some way with these tweets and the manner in which he is attacking politicians?
We are not embarrassed at all.
You're not embarrassed at all? Do you support him completely then?
We support him. My son. My son has a full support as my son.
He has the full support.
But he does not do.
Right.
He's quite entitled to do that. So, and I respect his independence.
Okay. KK Modi, appreciate your joining us.